Alhamdulillah. Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen, Alladhi khalaqa samawati wal ardeen, wassalatu wassalamu ala rasulihil kareem, sayyidil anbiya wa mursaleen, wa ala alihi wa ashabihi ajma'in, amma ba'd, faqad qala ta'ala fil Qur'an al-Majeed, a'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajeem, bismillahir rahmanir rahim, ya ayyuhal ladhina amanu attaqullaha haqqa tuqatihi, wa la tamutunna illa wa antum muslimun. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم يغفر لكم ذنوبه ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما أما بعد فقد قال تعالى في القرآن المجيد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم وهذا كتاب أنزلناه مباركة Mubarakun fattabi'uhu wattaku la'allakum turhamun. We give thanks and praise to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for affording us this opportunity to be in this masjid, to worship Him and to glorify His name. And we send durood and salam upon our noble Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. My respected brothers, we often hear of this word barakah. And people will make dua for each other, and they will say, Barakallahu feek. The Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when he made dua for a marriage couple, he will say, Barakallahu lak, wa baraka alaykum, wa jam'a baynakuma fi khair. So, we're asking ourselves here today, but what is the definition of the word baraka? You see, for us to actually define the word using a phrase might be difficult because English language is limited when it comes to actually defining what barakah means. Some scholars tend to say that barakah actually means being able to achieve more with few. For example, a person might purchase a toy for $100. And a kid wouldn't play with a toy for 2 or 3 days and put the toy away. And they may simply purchase a tennis ball for $1, and that kid would play with that tennis ball for the remaining of their lives. We will say, Alhamdulillah, this dollar that we pay for this tennis ball has barakah. Likewise, a marriage couple, they may save $10,000, young people, to go on a cruise. They go on the cruise, and throughout the cruise, they're fighting and arguing. And there's an old man and an old woman. They spent $1 to purchase a cone, an ice cream cone, and they're speaking and laughing for 45 minutes of their lives. We say, Alhamdulillah, that dollar had barakah. So, we say maybe one of the possible definitions is that we're able to achieve more with few. Some others say that you're able to do much more work in very little time. And some other people will say, well, you know, it generates a lot of great benefit with very little effort. So now we ask ourselves, how is it that we can invoke barakah into our dua? What techniques or technique we can use to achieve barakah in our dua? And one of the recommendations made by the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, Allahumma barik li ummati fi bukuriha, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has put barakah in our mornings. So the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to advise us that we should make the dua in the morning because it is a period and a period of time where our duas not only will be accepted, but we will have barakah in what we ask in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for. A next possible technique that we can use to achieve barakah in our lives, and all of us would like to have barakah on a daily basis, is the recommendation of at least reciting and reading Al-Quran the final revelation to mankind, to by Allah to us, as part of our daily lives, to recite portions of the Quran every day. Why? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in chapter 6, verse 155 of the Holy Quran, وَحَذَا كِتَابٌ, and this book, أَنْزَلْنَاهُ, we have revealed it as a mubarak, mubaraka, as a blessings. فَاتَّبِعُوهُ, so follow it, وَاتَّقُوا لَعَلَّكُمْ تُرْحَمُونَ, and fear Allah that you may receive His mercy. It came in a hadith of the Rasul sallallahu alayhi wasallam. He said, "La taj'alu buyutukum." Do not make your homes al-muqabir. Do not make your homes graveyards. Inna shaytan, indeed shaytan, yanfiru min al-bayt. Indeed shaytan runs away, leaves a home. الَّذِي يَقْرَأُ سُورَةَ الَّذِي يَقْرَأُ فِيهِ سُورَةَ الْبَقَرَ. Indeed, shaitan runs away from a home in which the surah al-Baqarah is recited. So, likewise, it is said, according to Abu Hurairah radiallahu an, it becomes, when the Quran is recited in our homes, it becomes spacious for its inhabitants, and the good of it becomes plentiful. The angels come towards that home, and the devil leaves and desists from entering such a home. Likewise, it is said that in the house in which the Quran is not being recited, then it becomes cramped, and it becomes, the inhabitants doesn't feel that there's a lot of barakah and blessings and goodness emanating from that home, and the devil comes to it and the angel desists from coming into it. So my respected brothers, reciting Quran is a source of great barakah and blessings for us on a daily basis. Likewise, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was instructed by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah said to him, قُلْ اِدْعُوا اللَّهِ. قُلْ اِدْعُوا اللَّهِ means invoke and say the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So, respected brothers, the advice here is before we attempt to do anything, before we start to do anything, we should recite Bismillah, because Bismillah unlocks the divine barakah in what we are about to do. So if we are about to start our job, we should say Bismillah. Something as insignificant as playing a sport, and before we start to play that sport, we say Bismillah, we are demonstrating that, oh Allah, you have the power and the command to do this and to make it complete and wholesome, and also to achieve maximum blessings we can get from it. So therefore, starting in your name, before we go into our cars, we say Bismillah. Before we unlock the doors for a business, we should say Bismillah. And there's so many times and so many examples, but the bottom line is, before we attempt to do something, we should invoke the name of Allah if we want to achieve the barakah in what we are about to do. You see, the Rasul sallallahu alaihi wasallam said to us, "Kullu amrin dhi balin lam yubda'a bi bismillah fa huwa aqta." Any important work that does not begin with Bismillah is imperfect. And likewise, in another hadith and another narration similar, he said, "Kullu amrin dhi balin lam yubda' bi bismillah fa huwa abtar." Said, any work or any important work that does not begin with Bismillah is devoid of barakah. So we thank and praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for affording us this opportunity so that we can attend to this Jummah and get a few reminders. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to bless us with this ability to always inculcate and ask and implore and invoke barakah in our daily lives. Wa akhi da'wan alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. La ilaha illallah. الحمد لله الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له ونشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله أما بعد فقد قال تعالى في القرآن المجيد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد اللهم بارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد وقيم الصلاة